Hello and welcome to Nikolai's Genetics Lessons, and today's problem is the genotype of F1 individuals in tetrahybrid cross is, as you see, heterozygous for all four genes, assuming independent assortment of these four genes. What are the probabilities that F2 offspring would have the following genotypes? So basically we asked what would happen, what probabilities would be if we would cross genotype that is heterozygous for each gene with another genotype that is also going to be heterozygous for the same genes. So total four genes we have here, and these four genes in diploid organism would make eight alleles. So the first allele, the first gene would be gene A, we see here and here, then gene B, we see here in both parents, gene C, and the last one would be gene D. And as you see, both parents in F1 generation are heterozygous for each gene. So how we are going to solve this problem? Basically, when we told that these genes independently assortment, that means that these genes are on the different chromosomes. So the probability of the different genotypes that these genes can make are independent. So we can use Punnett square in order to find probability for each gene separately. For example, what is the probability that the progeny would be homozygous recessive for the gene A? Let me build a simple Punnett square. So one parent would be heterozygous, another parent, as you see, also heterozygous. And when we cross two such parents, we can find probability that the progeny would be homozygous dominant, heterozygous, or homozygous recessive. And as you see, probability that the progeny would be homozygous recessive, as we see here in this example, would be 1/4. So we can put probability that progeny would be homozygous recessive for the gene A as 1/4. What is the probability that progeny would be homozygous recessive for the gene B? Because parents heterozygous for the gene B, I'm not going to draw new Punnett square. You just imagine that we are going to have the same picture. Instead of capital A, we would have capital B. Instead of small a, we would have a small b. So probability also would be 1/4. So 1/4 for the gene B, 1/4 for the gene C to be homozygous recessive, and 1/4 for the gene D. When we have independent probabilities, we have to use a product rule. And as you see, the answer would be that probability of such an event that plant would be homozygous recessive for all four genes in F2 generation would be 1 out of 256. Now let's consider this genotype. Probability for the plant to be heterozygous would be 2 out of 4 or 1/2. So 1/2 here for the gene A. For the gene B, probability also would be 1/2. For the gene C would be also 1/2. And for the gene D also would be 1/2. And once again, we use a product rule in order to find a probability that all these independent probabilities would happen simultaneously in a plant. And probability of such an event would be 1/2 multiplied by 1/2 would be 1/4, multiplied by 1/2, 1/8, and multiplied by 1/2 would be 1/16. and what is the probability of this genotype in the progeny. And this is going to be 1/4, 1/4, and 1/4 for each allelic pair. And once again, we use the product rule, and the answer would be the same as in the first example, where we have 1/4 probability for homozygous recessive, but also we have the same probability, that is 1/4, for a plant to be homozygous dominant. So the answer also would be the same. Probability of such an event would be 1/256. Example D would be 1/2 for the first allelic pair, 1/4 for the second, 1/4 for the third, and 1/2 for the last one. And once again, we use a product rule, and the answer would be 1/64. And the last example, we would have probability for the gene A to be heterozygous 1/2, for the gene B to be homozygous dominant 1/4, for the gene C to be homozygous dominant 1/4, and for the gene D to be homozygous recessive is 1/4. So when we multiply all these probabilities, the answer would be 1/128. So this is probabilities to have such genotypes in F2 generations. Of course, this is not the whole list of all probable genotypes. So now I hope you know how to solve analogous problems. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates. And see you in the next video. Goodbye.